Hello everyone, this is Juan from Kenhub and welcome to another anatomy tutorial where this time I'm going to be talking about the different muscles of the anterior neck. So what I'm going to be doing here is describing the different muscles that we find on the anterior portion of your neck. And right now we're looking at the neck anteriorly, and you can see that if we were to remove skin, fat, vessels, and nerves, we would be left with then the bones that you see here and some of the muscles. Now I'm going to be removing this muscle here, known as the platysma, to then expose the other collection or the entire collection of muscles that will be covered here on this tutorial. We will be covering or talking about the different origins, insertions, innervation, and functions associated to all of these muscles. These muscles that define the anterior portion of your neck. Now, the list includes the sternocleidomastoid, the scalene muscles, the infrahyoid muscle group, the suprahyoid muscle group, the longus capitis muscle, the longus coli muscle, and the platysma, the first one that I removed from the image. So quite a lot to cover on this tutorial. Let's start off with this one that you see here highlighted in green. This is known as the sternocleidomastoid muscle. And this muscle is a two-headed muscle of the neck. And you have one on each side of the neck, as you can clearly see on this image. The muscle lies superficially so that it is both easily visible and palpable. Thus, every one of us has already seen it or know about it. But now you know the actual name that we use to describe it in anatomy. You can see and touch the left one when you turn your head to the right and vice versa. Now, in terms of the origins for the sternocleidomastoid muscle, this muscle has two heads, a sternal head and a clavicular head. Now, the sternal head originates from the manubrium of the sternum, as you can clearly see here from this image, while the clavicular head will originate from the medial one-third of the clavicle, as you can also see from here. So two heads for the sternocleidomastoid muscle. In terms of the insertion point for this muscle, the insertion is the mastoid process of the temporal bone, and also the superior nuchal line of the occipital bone will serve as an insertion point for the sternocleidomastoid. When it comes to the innervation for this muscle, it is innervated by the accessory nerve or cranial nerve number 11, and you can clearly see here highlighted in green and piercing through the sternocleidomastoid muscles. And notice that here on this image, we're looking at these structures from a posterior view. This video is not over yet. Continue watching now the full video at kenhub.com. We have lots more videos like this one available to our premium members on our website, not to mention all the fun quizzes, related articles, and atlas sections. So click on the button in the middle to watch the full-length video and master anatomy.